I want to hear all of it again, and for me it's really well played, but it is in many bits quite serious. Yeah, concerned and music where he writes allegro aperto, so allegro aperto, open, you're open, and I think there is some things you can open wider and be more talkative in what you do. So let's start at the very beginning. First entrance here. The mi. So then give it a little more a feeling of a sunrise. And maybe your next favorite would be the G. So maybe don't play a button. So that the sweetness of that becomes, if you think about every quarter note with a little push, then the aim is not as great. So the first one actually can be really the, really a searching sound. And choreography, this moment in, I don't think it has happened before, that a concerto starts, the orchestra finishes, and nothing happens. And then an adagio starts in piano. So maybe don't you already kind of yeah. And then search the note from somewhere. The mi is challenged because of the fourth finger? No? Well, then for me the development could not only be in loudness but also just from here it is the warmness of them. You make a real legato in both the slurs, and as I'm for a moment a professor, for me the vibrato is really a part of your language. So if you go, this is very nice if that last E that doesn't want anything anymore, also doesn't want anything more. Both here. And here, so in the next, all these last notes, end of a word. One last go at it, yeah. Your sound does not really change between all those notes for my ears. And from this, it's, I think, if you had a word, we all have stresses and non-stresses in our words, in whatever language. And this is the, what I don't hear, that is if an M starts in C sharp. Yeah, just go from here. Yeah, it has the same intensity, the C sharp. Yeah, if you would see yourself. right? Just that. Yeah. And for me, if I'm mean, you play. And for my. Abendrot. Yeah, it is not Abendrot. Whatever the word is, you use the same tools, left and right hand for it. Also for your sound production. Try to stay away from doing too much of this. I'm not saying you should play louder, but a singer would not, within his vowel, a slur is a vowel, he would not always go in and out when he wants to project. And then we have three A's. Indicated by the trill, I think that's the note where you are aiming for. Okay, next part. Okay. If I think of this wild boy Mozart at the time, and he writes Allegro aperto, and I think he wants to just catch everybody in the room, and I hear a bit of. Yeah, I'm being mean, but. And then he gets playful, and all the different things. And of course this. applies also very. Yeah? I know control is good, but you play. It's either or, but both ways to have dum ba then makes it into a march, which it is not. So I think the natural feel for it is da da di da yum ba da di da ta da da. Or so the second note would have a entonung, a non-emphasis. Yeah, yum ba da di da ta da ta. And this way you make it into a dance somehow. Yeah. That's what he likes in comparison to an aria. He loves to challenge his singers, but to have a soprano do. That's quite a challenge. That's what works so fine on the fiddle. So really be a tenor. And it doesn't have to be as if the singing is going up, going on. But how do we make we protect that project here? You do You make your arm heavy. I know it depends on the piano and on the size of orchestra you have, but with orchestra in the low register, you have to have a different way of playing. Can you just play the whole opening slowly from the whole, just from here without piano? Slowly, but with all the things we want to do. Yeah? air for those two notes.
Yes.
And that, and now that's the sound. If you're, yeah, really lean against the string, and before you're not playing on the string, or are you playing that on the string? Oh, okay, yeah. Can you just do it for me, the whole thing, once slowly, and even in there try it. The joy of not, like something is falling down and crashing in a good way, yeah? I feel you're getting tight, leaning forward, which is not good for what you're playing. Yeah. If anything, you need to be more concise and wider open for that. Yeah. Okay, now you're back to tempo kind of, but play it in tempo for me, and this expression of joy. Try to give it to the whole thing again without piano. Yeah. Yeah. And very good. But then you're back to. For the technical sake, I would encourage you. Get every slur with a heavy bow. Yeah. Heavy bow, low shoulder. Yeah. And then that's our scene, yeah. And it's definitely there. This feeling of okay, a difficult wild beginning, and now he's really flirting and playing. No, that's maybe a bit complicated. It's probably Allegro aperto needs open strings. Aperto. Good. Well done. So it needs a little projection of what you actually, how much joy you dare to project on us. And the other thing is just a bit technical, that you shouldn't, not in the opening and not here, carry the bow, but let it rest in the string. For me, the next engine, bam, ba-da-ding, they finish in forte. And if you then go lyrical, it's maybe a bit disappointing because it is a trumpet motif, no? Bam, ba-da-ding. Dialogue than the same thing. Yeah?
Otherwise, three times
would
be the same.
I would not do that. You can start in piano or mezzo forte, but I'm just about the character of this. I think it's a trumpet. Yeah? You play it. You can sing it. You don't dare to. So then it sounds, again, the slur and the other sound too similar. Yeah? Just try once more to let your arm not go out of the string. The whole thing. How do you feel? Yeah? Then maybe don't use your vibrato for the most beautiful moment. Yeah? First is loud, second is soft. This is like this. So play with it. It's generally a good idea, but it should still sound alive all the time. One last time about the bit before. I think you should dare to use more different sounds. And if you agree, dum ba da dim. Why? What does the vibrato do for a motif like that? Different colors if you rethink your vibrato. Okay, go on here. Yeah. And just one thing that this is a call stop. And somebody else is answering, so it doesn't have to be yum, papa, from timing. Yum, papa, yum. There's something irrational. Good. And it's there, not to door. If that were a slur, it would. And then that we don't. And then yada-dee-da-da. Yeah. It's too serious, yeah. Hallo, hallo. Try one second. Be aware that it's a whole orchestra playing this. Sing it out here, yeah? Yeah. What kind of a theme is that? How beautiful is it on a scale from 1 to 10? A 10. Okay, I would have given it a cool 2 because I don't think it's meant to be beautiful. And you play a bit careful. And for me, he puts a dash on every one of them, puts 8 notes, and then the second fiddle. So he's. No. Now even worse. It's a great invention because it's not a great invention. Yeah, placed in the right moment. So it just vibrato. I think call a spade a spade. Okay, more questions.
one long. Does it have a reason? It's good to be long because then it's easier after, but that's not an argument, okay? Go into your fiddle. I know, it's always because it's easier, but the harmonic changes on the one and not on the three. Okay. So the pa-pa-pa is only so it's easier to do, but it doesn't count. I would never in Mozart use the kind of sound and heavy bow because it just doesn't help the music. But this, you're not really hitting the, not hitting the string, like that, going slightly above it, and so it doesn't project enough. Uh-huh. And do you know what he writes in this, in the beginning? How it's the dynamic are in the orchestra introduction. It's 40 here. And then piano. Not to do that only because in the solo he never writes anything. It doesn't make too much sense for me because he likes the joke of the harmony on this. On the F sharp. Nothing happened, then again this zwischen dominant and then release. So do a bit like in the introduction. And in a concerto, that can really be open and the sound doesn't come if you go. Yeah. Piano, you still can make a legato in there. Mama? You do a tiny. You do it slow. Like a mouse here. Yeah, piano, yes, but still with a core in the sound. Nochmal? Are you content with the feel of it in your bow? Okay. Sehnsucht. Yeah, we have so little places where we sing in this moment, but it's not a. I think it's not enough if it's strong. Yeah, not four equal beats. And I would suggest one. Later you do. Yeah, I think should be the same here with over the string. Don't use the fourth finger, too complicated. It's more fun in a way, yeah? They have the forte on every half beat and so for me the whole scenery in the opera, all of a sudden somebody runs in and gives her a letter and she gets really bad news, which for me much more to the harmonies and to the actually written forte in there. So that the first entrance is not simply melancholic, but also agitato. Yeah? But in order to allow them to play this forte, you have to play not. I'm really being exaggerating, but it is a. There may not be a consonant in the middle of it. Yeah? Stay in the string. Is that not like saying? And you play really until the ladder. So which is the dissonant note in here? And if you're keep that down, you're taking that away. Yeah? And the whole orchestra has fought it before, and when you come in, everybody plays piano. So you don't have to. So it's like resignation after. And then you have another chance. Yeah, once more. Really, go in your fiddle. Thank you. going through all this. It's for me the. No, it can be loud, but joyful. Yeah. No. Yeah, yeah, bitter, down, bitter, and it's twice always the same. So maybe not down, bitter, down, bitter, yum, bitter, down, bitter, down, bitter, down. And then it is nice, I guess, to either do either a diminuendo or leading into it, but most importantly, not stubborn. Yeah. Yeah, time-wise, dynamically. I don't know where to go. And then. But it sounds a bit disappointing. Yeah? Think of the nicest name you want to hear and then say the name. And it's four different harmonies and intensities. For me, it's the feeling of a scoop. And for you, it's the feeling of. Of an arrow. So I think especially the upper, it should be but you know that you don't the what's the name you want to hear there?
Mother, mama,
that's angry, yeah, mama. Yeah, especially in the upper, maybe for practice reasons, don't use the whole bow, yeah, it's enough 2 centimeters for mama. Yeah, and then release. I'm getting up all to the high A. But let us feel the joy of doing that, yeah? So we have a long one, and then two short ones. Ta. Same applies here. Begin to da 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 da. Dum ba dum. Ach mama, ach mama. Yeah, you need, especially in the cadenza when the harmony goes away, you need the explanation why you go so sweet on us, honest. And yeah. Yeah. I go once more from the. Vibrato, but you have to, you know your cadenza, but for us you have to explain whatever the tempo is that it belongs to you. If you play we don't know yet what it is, so whatever the tempo is, to recognize what it is. Three. Don't start for this. And then the E major. Just C major, light in A major. No. Again, that we recognize the shape even though it gets more complicated with the accompaniment. Can you do the first one? Now that we expect the why don't you make the A major a moment of beauty and joy? It sounds exactly the same as the measure before. So. This is where you are at your aim for the top note and have it play for. Can you? Try the. Okay, well done.